Welcome back to the stream. We have Newcastle I-Beam versus Adelaide Apocalypse, Outbreak Apocalypse.
Yeah, I could hear without it.
Joining me in the commentary box, we've got Narelle. Welcome.
Hey, how you going?
Now, Narelle, you are from Adelaide?
Yeah, I am. Yeah, I play with the women's team, Sig Theory. So, here to support the boys on the weekend, both teams.
Yeah, fantastic. Now, how have the Apocalypse boys gone today so far?
They're not done. They're really starting to gel together as a team, which is good to see. So we'll see what they come out with this game. It'll be a tough game.
Yeah, great. So who's the key players we should watch out for?
Well, on this line, we've probably got the handler wise, we've got Scott, Rex should be making the plays a bit. So receiver wise, Aiden's a little bit of a young gun, so we'll see how we go.
All right. Fill over the top to Davis. There's a vertical stack, looking for the space in the middle. Dumps it back to Rex Johnson.
There we go. Ooh.
Yeah, it's good pressure, Billy.
Bit of the early nerves, I think.
PB and lefty back.
Looks a little bit hasty.
Go, B!
Johnson! Big deep! Wait, TD! Bring it closer!
Ivan picks up the disc. And number 9's Chris Stoddard. He's a mover shaker on that offensive line. And he long huck to the end zone. Bit out of my sight. It's a turnover. Tim Hayes not able to pull that in at the end zone.
So it looks like we've got Rex Johnson, Phil Shields at the top. Start again. See how we go. So we got Rex up on the line. Quick dump. Back over Rex. Swing to Tim Davis. Got some long action happening. Back to Rex. Little dishy's working fine. Dump reset. Oh, nice cut down the line by Phil. There we go. Huck long by McKenzie. Ooh, bit of a pack. Turnover.
Find the player.
Big defence from I-Beam there. Number 9 for I-Beam, Chris Stoddard is walking towards the disc. He'll pick it up. Bringing up to the end zone. I-Beam set up in a horizontal stack. Early long cut. Fades off one hand. Jack Gray receives. He looks to his left, but the force is now tight from Shields. Hayes with the outreach grab over the top. Carlos reels it in. Great return, big gainer down the field there. That's going to make a big difference if we can pull off those kind of throws in this game today.
Yeah, a little bit of wind, so it was a good catch in the end. Get the goal in and start again.
Looks like Apocalypse has a larger squad than they took to regionals.
Yeah, that's right. So selections will happen after this tournament. So we've got a few of the boys, they've got to fight for their spot. Got a couple of extras that couldn't make it to regionals as well that have joined the team, which is good to see, good for development. So that Outbreak Mountain's got a bit of a smaller team this time and got more players into Apocalypse.
gloved hand of Chris Hill throwing that disc in.
For the 4x race. Couple of give goes, gets ground. Down the sing. Little dump off the shields. Looks like they're having a bit of downfield trouble. Big huck up. Easy! What a grab. Surrounded by two I-beam players.
Big grab. There's an early highlight for us. The big outside in comes in. Grab out in front. And who took that?
Israel Sarundo. I was watching a game earlier today and he took a couple of good grabs in the end zone again. So seems like that's his role in the team for a little bit today.
No, in a developing team, not saying anything, it's the first time I've seen Sarondo play, I can't speak for him, but guys with roles in teams is really important. You've got to come together, and if you're given a job,
you've
got to trust your teammates to be able to do it, and that's really important at this level.
Yeah, that's it. It's both teams all trained together at one club, all around each other, all know what they got to do to win the games. So we got McKenzie, big pull down the I-beam.
Let's go, Bray!
Looks like I-beam's setting up in a horizontal. Davey's picking up the disc with the disc in the middle. Lindsay Brown goes for the big gainer. Spot on. Chris Hill to Tim Hayes. That downfield throw, incredible hit.
It's a great play by Arbin. Such power through this wind. Straight to where it wanted to be, needed to be. In the end zone. Job done.
How would you describe Apocalypse's play generally? Do they prefer to go long, play a patient game?
They've definitely got a long game. That's probably something that I've noticed has really improved from last season to this season is their long game is quite strong.
I-beam disc in hand, it looks like Chris Stoddard ready to pull the disc in. Oh, it's floating towards that sideline. Major drop. Shields is a little underside.
Brick's called.
Late brick call.
It was rather late, wasn't it?
Does look like a junk defence being put on by IB here. Which is a little bit different.
Yep. So over to Tim Davis. Rather congested on this sideline. Loses some ground back to Johnson. Still a little bit stuck. Got the get out of jail, big hug to Mornay. That's a great grab by Mornay. Off the barbler. Everyone's filtering down, Sarondo. There's a call. Is that a pick call?
It's a pick call in a zone. I'm not sure I've seen too much of that.
Potentially retracted.
Whatever it is, violation.
So we've got Sorondo, plays back in. Dump to Davis. Nice break to Shields. Crossfield, oh, Mornay. Nearly two great grabs in that point.
Hayes picking up the disc. Swings to Stoddard. Whoa, contested, a little bit of communication. Would have helped there. And the shovel over the top. Carlos with a lot of the disc in the middle. He's very patient and he gets a throw off.
It's pretty good defense here by Obrey. We're really getting in the way. Stopping a few of those undercuts. That's a nice throw.
Long put to Bacalis, just out of his reach and out of Hayes' reach as well.
Quick reset by Davis, got the hammer over the top.
Lindsay Brown, quick movement and he's off. Stoddard, oh, the disc just pops up in that breeze. There's a huge contest, that's going to be contested.
The breeze is really becoming a factor now in this game.
Lindsay Brown's already decided he's contesting that and he's sending that straight back. You can decide for yourself what you think the call was on that one.
Yeah.
Disc back in. Stoddard with the disc.
It's really nice offense by Obeam. Nice and calm.
That brings the score to 3-1 to Obeam. Now, you're right, Norell. They're looking just really calm on offense there. Like, they know their game and they're in control. It was early pressure from outbreak. They just worked their way through and when the disc did turn over, they fought hard to get it back. So, Norell, how's Zig Theory travelling this year?
Yeah, not doing too bad. So, we came third in our Southern Regionals. So we qualify for Div 1, which is a good sign. Got a training camp in a few weeks, and then we'll be heading straight to Nationals. So it's been good so far, so see what we can do on that.
Davey with disc in hand, he'll be pulling. Big bladey pull. Looks like it's just landed in.
Right in the back corner of the end zone. Johnson to McKenzie to Shields. And that's out.
Obeam in fantastic position here. That pull really put them in that position. That intangible pressure on outbreak, a little bit too much in the throw going over the head. Davey's going to bring it back, looks like, on the cone.
That's a perfect position for Obeam right now.
Daly Water with the disc. Dump to Davey. A little bit of a crowded end zone at the moment. He's looking for a bit of space, but outbreak poaching up that space quite well. Daly Water with the disc. Again, not a lot of space. Chris Hill looking for a break. Gets that break. Stuart Sinclair running into the space on the break side for the score. That leaves Obeam at 4-1. Affectionately known as Stu Mack. Stuart Sinclair. Cinderella, I heard that Obeam have had an absolute shocker trip to getting here. They've had a cancelled flight, something at like 1 a.m. last night. The train from Newcastle to Sydney wasn't running because of track work, so they had a bus there instead. A lot of them are running off not much sleep.
is probably why they're getting the job done. They're ready to go home.
They are probably very ready for the afternoon nap. There we see a UConn play of the day. That pull, fantastic way to start a play, and it's putting your team in the best possible position to get that defence, and that's exactly what happened. Not too often you'll see the pull on the highlights of the day, but a good one deserves it. It's underappreciated part of the game, I reckon.
Definitely undervalued. This with Stapleton. A little bit of confusion going on in the stack. The outbreak. Off the Barbara. Julian. Back in the hands of Johnson. Nice little flick to Tim. Back across to Mitchell. And then we've got a pick call. Right in the middle of the stack. So coming in on two. Big disc up. Great grab by Davis. Right in the end zone. Just what Elbrick needed.
UConn Sports, you can just play of the day, that grab in the end zone. That brings outbreak to 4-2. Just that effective throw over the top, breaking open, I think, quite well. Yeah. That goal to Tim Davis in the end zone. So the outbreak apocalypse using the full roster on the line. Listen to the call. Is that a tradition for the team?
It's becoming a tradition. Yeah, it's part of the building the culture of the club, getting around their mates, making sure that everyone knows what's going on. Sideline talk is very, very, very helpful, particularly in windy conditions when discs are up and all that. So, something that both outbreak teams have really been focusing on during their tourneys.
It's a very floaty pull. Lindsay Brown with the disc senses it to Ryan Davey. Anthony Vran with the disc in the centre, hands back to Lindsay Brown. Open under to Chris Stoddard, puts it over the top.
And another call.
I believe pick called. And I'm pretty sure that'll be sent back to the thrower as the receiver did seem to stop as he heard the call. Of course, the rule being that if he did make a go at grabbing it, he can't then turn around and say that he was distracted. So this disc returned to Chris Stoddard. About on the halfway line. Lindsay Brown, his dump in the centre of the field. It looks like a floaty horizontal kind of stack with a tight man defensive. Stoddard goes along again, looking for the big play. It's worked before, it'll work again, and that is Jack Gray with the score in the end zone for I-Beam. Scores are 5-2 to I-Beam. We are 20 minutes in through this game. I-Beam looking strong. What do you think Outbreak's going to need to do to respond here?
Then they've probably just got to get their offense together a little bit. I think there's been a couple of unnecessary errors that where they haven't been able to get their goals in. So once they've got that down pat, then got to start getting some Ds. Got to start getting these breaks back. Buffer's getting a bit big, so don't want it too much bigger than this. With this wind, be tough to get back.
You might hear the wind through the microphone here. The wind is picking up now. It's coming over as commentators on the side on with Ivan on the left. Break on the right. It's coming over our right shoulder, cross field, and it's definitely picking up a bit of speed.
Yeah, this is going to be a real factor soon. If it keeps going the way it is. It's meant to be rain later tonight, so it's probably losing the sponsorship sign.
Yes, first sponsorship sign blown away. Sign of the times.
Alright. So it starts here, our break. Going to get this goal in.
Alright, we've got a bit of a junk defence thrown for the first time in this game.
So, back to the middle of Johnson. Seems like offence is revolving around him in the middle at the moment. That's a K, back to Johnson. Davis. Back to Johnson. Yeah. I think the offence is a little unsure at the moment. Across to Mitchell.
We have seen a transition back into man defence here from Mike.
Great cut by Mornay. Really provided that option that they needed. Davis looking for the hammer. Johnson, nice and calm. Julian, Phil wants it. Phil's calling for it. Great work by Albright. That was a really well worked point. Caught in the end by Tim Davis. So that's two for Tim. Really picking the spaces, sitting there good.
Bouncing around quite well. Patience. We've seen quite some hasty offense from them so far. So hopefully a sign of the times for them.
Maybe the wind is a good sign for them.
Outbreak holding their offensive point there. So we have the scores at 5-3. Pulling that disc in, it's fallen a little short, and there was a junk defence thrown on by Outbreak. Ryan Davey picks up the disc. Cross to Lindsay Brown. Breaks for the swing to Stuart Sinclair. Chris Stoddart over the top to Davey. Back to Davey. Big break across to Sinclair. Stoddard looks to the end zone, looks off. Sinclair surveys his options, goes for the scoop over the top, just reaches Davey. Pops it over the top to Delywater. Easy as you like. Outbreak may reconsider a zone defence against an I-beams team that seems really comfortable with that kind of play.
Yeah, they really worked around quite well at that point. A couple of good breaks, and that was all they needed to open up the space, gain some ground, and then just into the end zone.
Again, bloody rounds, hammers, and scubas.
Yeah, and that scuba just there.
Outbreak would be happier seeing those types of throws than than your more conventional throws. So it's they have much higher percentage chance of being popped up in the breeze. Kale Silva, the mystery number 44 on our team list has been added now. He has one score against his name, and now has a name against his name. So that's convenient. Chris Hill pulling that in. That is a floaty disc.
That's a great pull, Barbie. So got Sorondo with the disc. Oh, wayward throw. Turfed.
Not sure if that was a foot on that disc or just the foot putting off the throw.
Yeah,
Jacko with the forehand huck. A lot of energy in that. It goes over both offensive and defensive players' heads.
Perhaps good pressure by Tim Davis. Got the turn. Alright, so Rex Johnson picking up the disc. That wind's gushing again. See how we go. This to Kay. Little backhand to Soren though. And a pick call.
I always love that moment when only one person doesn't hear the pick call.
Poor little Kay.
And they think they're having the cut of their life before they have to pull themselves up and return their 50 metres back.
So Sorondo looking for the break, not quite there. Looks like he's going to hug it. Congestion with the dump. Off to Mornay, great throw by Mornay. Aiden, big up. Let's go Sorondo, big lay. Oh, very close.
Got to wonder if that was on grass, whether he would have laid.
Yeah.
Stuart Sinclair with the disc and the forehand around. So that's to catch that. Oh, using knee, why not? Jack Gray. And the forehand before he stands up.
Well, that's just a little bit unfair, I think.
It's improvising play at best. But it's a score. It was a score.
It's only...
Get out, break.
I believe it must be a timeout called. 7-3 is the scores at the moment. 7-4. 7-3.
Boys, score 7-3. 7-3, that's what the score is instead.
Mike, are you 100% on score, Mike? Yeah.
Is this a timeout?
Yeah.
classic score confusion as the scoreboard is blown by the wind. The score is 7-3. So far for Outbreak Apocalypse, we have two scores for Tim Davis, 1-2 Sorondo, and we have one each for Newcastle I-Beam, spreading it around to Gray, Picullis, Daly Water, Sinclair, Lindsay Brown, Burt, and Silva. So after that confusion of a half break turned timeout, we're back on the line. Ryan David with disc in hand. He'll be pulling from the right screen.
Big bloody pull. Rolled out the back this time.
There's no touch on it, so he'll walk that up to the end zone line. Some kind of junky zone being thrown by Newcastle.
So you got Rex Johnson bringing it back in. Over to Shields, back to Johnson, over to McKenzie. Really congested there. That's a great throw by Rex, really opened it all up. Kay's got the dish, little dishy to Tim Davis. He wants that hark. Julian, get there. It's a great day by him.
Chris Hill with the defence there, just falling into the space. Ambitious, but potentially high reward put there. Nearly coming off. Just hand slipping in the way at the last second. Ryan David with disc in hand on the sideline. Being a horizontal stack, looking downfield to Chris Stoddard. The very stylish slide on the leg to Tim Hayes. Back to Stoddard. Looking down the line for the cut to Hayes. Not on. Little dump to onto Davey. Cross to Sinclair. Pulls the trigger on the forehand. Now that is half score.
Seems like Albrecht's got a little bit of work to do on their defense right here. Don't want to pick this back. Got to tighten it right up. But great work by Ivan.
The UConn play of the day sees this forehand from Stuart Sinclair, rifles it in there to Chris Hill, right in the bread basket. A bit of a chest mark there. Of course, today's stream brought to you by UConn Sports with their discs, apparel, equipment. Jump on the website, check out what they've got, and we're thanking them very much for coming on board.
Why is I-beam called I-beam? You're the commentator, you're meant to know stuff.
I'm meant to ask questions.
Oh, I don't know the answer either.
Welcome back for the second half. I-beam versus Outbreak Apocalypse. One of two apocalypses competing here in the men's division at SMO. Disc is pulled in with I-beam on offense. Misread on the pull, so the disc's gone straight over Stuart Sinclair's head there. So Lindsay Brown with the disc in hand. Davey, pretty little flick down the line. Farnful off that that throwaway, pushes along, but the throw is not on. Jack Gray swings it around to Stuart Sinclair. To Farnful, looks down the field, not on, dumps it back to Sinclair. There is a pick called, disc will return.
Seems like Outbreak have lifted their defense coming out of half, which is a good sign to see. Definitely an area that we needed to focus on. See if they can get a turn. Get one of these breaks back.
Yeah, the impassioned speech from Shields at halftime was that you can't wait, you just got to go. And it's going to take a bit of lifting from everyone to do that. Sinclair with disc in hand. Finds Gray. The under. That
still
big step around. And error from Davey. I think Delia Ward maybe not on the same wavelength. And throw to empty space.
So we've got McKenzie to Stapleton.
Pick call.
Another pick. Interesting reset. Big hug from McKenzie. Down to Barber.
In the end, no contest even being able to made. Great to be just standing in position.
A little bit of frustration there from Tom, but keep pushing.
Davey's walking to the disc. He's going to be picking up horizontal stack for I-beam. Stoddard and Gray in the middle, and Daly Water and Farmful on the wings. The disc is over the top. Big contest.
That is
huge
a great
grab.
Oh, and unfortunate turn.
Immediate throwaway. That deserved better, that grab.
Definitely did. That was a fantastic grab by Sang.
Move, Dougie, move.
A filthy mark means Lindsay Brown cannot get the around throw on. Gets the long, and teammates, unfortunately. Oh, well, okay, made that harder than it needed to be, but Stoddard has the disc. He's frustrated that there's no cuts, but he finds one eventually. Gray to Daly Water in the corner. And that makes the score 9-3. Now, upon research of why I-beam is I-beam, we have discovered they hardly know themselves. The general consensus was there's a lot of steel beams in Newcastle, and that's kind of their thing, so they're going to roll with it.
Don't know how green and brown uniform resembles steel beams, but...
Look, there's a lot of questions to be asked about the I-beam uniform, but got to say, big improvements on past I-beam uniforms.
Definitely agree on that one.
If the Adelaide teams were to be represented by an industry, what would it be?
I don't know. All our big companies keep going bust these days, so...
Chris Hill pulling in the disc.
Caught the pull. Rex off the field. Gets the disc back. Ooh. Close throw. Great pick up by Mitchell. Dishes it back to Johnson. Over the top. Hammer to Mornay. Great spot, Mornay. Back to Davis. Great cover by I-beam. Tim was really quite stuck there. Swings across the field to Johnson. He's getting stuck again. Collared his own by I-beam. Just keep swinging, keep swinging. Great pick up by Johnson. Shields, Davis, Shields, Davis. Kay, great spot by Kay. Shields, slowly working it up, slowly gaining that ground. Big swing by to Johnson. Mitchell. Dishy to Johnson. Gonna need a big break here.
So unfortunate, after scrapping through three quarters of the way down the field, unfortunately the cross-field blade.
Probably not the best option with this wind.
Yeah. He's got that breeze over his shoulder. It's going to get picked up most times.
Always going to push it wide there. That's right, restart.
Hill with the disc. To Hayes. Does a little pirouette and he finds Lindsay Brown. Swinging across the field to Mikhail Silva for the score. Silver second, that brings the score to 10-3. can see there on the replay, there's plenty of room. There's a paddock out on the break-hand side, and they were just able to utilise that space. And then we see that huge hammer, the Rainmaker. Went into a different world up there. Somehow didn't get picked up by that breeze. That energy you mentioned from Outbreak coming out after half maybe dissipated a little bit.
Yeah, it looks like it has.
It's kind of up to them to how they want to finish this game and what kind of attitude they're going to have for the last few points. I say last few points if I-Beam ticks over the way they have been. Of course, there's plenty of time in the game. We've still got 35 minutes of game time. And we never know what these wind conditions are going to do to the game.
Yeah, those breaks keep piling up with I-Beam keeps extending their buffer, so Outbreak kind of have to get a move on now if they want to try and change this. But I-Beam's playing really well at the moment.
That breeze is really picking up now, feeling that.
So we got Sing with the disc. He's got zone again from I-Beam. Trying to get around, back to Johnson. Still quite stuck on this sideline. Gotta figure out a way to break through, get it across. That's a nice throw by Johnson. Really opened it all up, back to Davis. Rex gets again.
He really wanted that through, probably wasn't on.
Hill
picking up the disc, looks straight downfield, it looks again. Pumps it and gets the downfield forehand to the center. Gray with the disc. Daly Water has a look. The bobble, and down.
Good touch on that by Sang. Oh.
Bizarre. Davis picks up the disc, looks straight to his opponent, says, "Do you want it back?" That disc was returned, and now Outbreak. He's moving against the zone of I-Beam.
So we got shields. Straight through the cup to Johnson. Not really sure where to go, but goes back to the sideline of shields. Back to Johnson. Give goes. Sits it up. Davis has got it. Turn over straight to I-Beam.
Did not anticipate the movement of the I-Beam player there. I-Beam just take their time to get back into some form of structure. They dump it back and then find Chris Hill downfield. Hayes looks for a shot into the end zone and finds Sinclair.
That's unfortunate by Outbreak. Now we've got some unforced errors creeping in. That's not helping their case. Silly turnovers, but that's all right. I-Beam's just taking their opportunities, getting those goals.
It's a light breeze to I-Beam, and it's a bit more of a gale for.
Yeah, that's it.
For Outbreak.
That's why you need those steel beams.
Bad puns brought to you by Yukon Sports today. We can't redeem that one. We're just going to let that one fly by. The score is 11-3 to I-Beam. Ryan Davey with disc in hand. He's going to be pulling from the right of screen. the I-beam line very comfortable with each other's plays and very happy for a mixed line to go on. They don't run a very long roster. They use all their players quite well. That is a fiery pull. That had heat on it. It hit the ground and Mackenzie really had no chance of getting the hand on that one. Not sure he wanted to. He's got a real job getting it off that opposite sideline now.
Yeah, it's going to be really tough with this win. So really pushing against him. That's a nice break. Davis. As you can see, this picked up by the wind, it just moves it enough.
Yeah, that higher release that just burnt him on that one.
Yeah.
Disc has end up on the other side of the opposite field. Just a little delay as we organise that. Pass to parcel, and disc is back with Ryan Davey. Lindsay Brown, his dump. So looking for that dump. It's a floaty disc. Outbreak as a play.
Great work by Daniel to get that D. So we've got Mackenzie, Stapleton, Davis. Quick movement here. It's a good sign. Julian. Oh, I got an injury called.
The call's in a lot of pain. I didn't see the incident.
Potentially a groin. It's been unfortunate for I-beam.
Whatever happened dropped him. Cramp, potentially? Give him, stretching him as if there's a cramp. So hopefully it's something minor like that, and we'll see him back later.
So we got Mackenzie with the disc. Nice throw to Davis. Strike up by Mackenzie and a pick called. Disc staying with Mackenzie. Play back in. Another strike up by Davis.
It's
and a goal.
It's filthy play down the sideline there.
Jammed it right up the sideline the whole way down.
Is
Kay with the goal.
Contact coming from Marks. There's tripping over players. I'm not sure that'll go in the highlights package. As we see it here again.
Windy shambles. You never know.
But a score is a score. So what's the pathway for players making getting to an outbreak in Adelaide?
So just a lot of league development. So basically we started at social leagues at where we get our unis heavily involved. So we've got a Flinders Social League and then a City Social League for UniSA and Adelaide Uni. So that's where our uni games players end up mostly, in the social leagues, and then they head to our South of State Leagues, where we offer a Div 1 and a Div 2 for split gender. And then they try and get a little bit of a taste of the higher standard ultimate that Adelaide offers, and then onto the outbreak trainings and then onto the outbreak teams. So that's why Apocalypse has been really great for outbreak this year. We've got some good competition for those players to still try and push themselves, no matter how developed your skills are and all that. So it's been really good for outbreak. It's been, over the last couple of years, we've had just some crazy improvements.
Yeah.
So it's been good. So big pull by Mackenzie.
Yeah, externally it looks like their setup is going in loops and bounds.
Yeah, absolutely.
Davey with the disc in the middle. Surveying the field, looking at his options. Finds Hill with the cross undercut. Wants downfield, but not on. Dumps to Davey.
Good defense here by Outbreak. Really lifted that up.
Stoddard with the disc. He finds Davey with the diagonal dump cut. It's really good cycling coming from I-beam, but a tight man defence at the moment. Lindsay Brown looks downfield, finds Davey on the dump cut, who flips that flick forward. Does not get any further than McKenzie.
Great pickup, I think. Again, wind just pushing those discs down into the ground.
You've really got to adapt your technique in this kind of wind. Don't have a lot of time to do it. It's a big backhand from Ryan Davey, looking for Hill, who just plants himself in front of his opponent. Takes that grab, finds Gray on the opposite wing now against that wind. Nice little flick, just opened up space. Sinclair recognises space, puts the throw up. Done and done.
Is that a call, maybe?
There is a call. I'm not sure when or where.
Seems to me the player's right in the middle. Unsure if that affected that goal, though.
The pick was called. It was his opponent. He was slow moving. I probably would say that he wouldn't have made the disc, but it was his direct opponent. They've agreed it didn't affect the play.
Good spirit by the teams.
That's a score to Stoddard, I believe. Scores are at 12-4. Advantage I-beam. It's really taken away the second half.
Yeah, it's really strong by I-beam. Come out after half and just really put the game away. Not fazed by the wind. They've got enough strength in their throws and their legs.
They're just one of those teams that just doesn't look fazed. They're not going to get super pumped. They're not going to get super down. They're just going to cruise through.
A lot of experience on the team. They just look so calm. It's good. Ducking out of the way. Nice break by Johnson. Over the field, back to Tim. Pick up by Mornay. Getting stuck on that sideline. Big overhead hammer. And that one got caught by the wind.
That's extremely ambitious with that wind over his shoulder.
Yeah, that's probably not the best choice.
As soon as that left his hand, it just shot off.
Okay. Oh. No outbreak players in sight.
Davey on that side saw it fly straight over his head. That Hill with the disc bringing it in. Finds Stoddard. The one glove pumps it through to Silva for his third goal.
No mucking around by I-beam. Get the turn. Get the disc in the end zone.
They have a habit of moving the disc towards the middle of the field. Just gives them options.
Yeah, that's it. Both sides.
Scores are 13-4. See a fantastic technique from Stoddard Abs, keeping that disc flat, not giving it a chance to be affected by the wind. Mm-hmm. may notice on your stream a lack of Yukon signs on the other side for the keen-eyed streamer. It's windy, they've been blown away, but we are, no matter what, still sponsored by Yukon Discs. The score is 13-4, 61 minutes gone. Chris Hill, big high pulling.
Johnson catching the ball. IBM getting down really quick, stopping that first pass. Johnson trying to go over the cup, not a great choice.
Telegraphing that pass quite a lot. Wins the ground with the disc now. Surveys the field, sees Jack Gray. Chases back, wants to be part of the action.
Couple of give goes, and that's a goal. Decision making starting to be a factor in this game now.
That's 14-4. Jack Gray with his second. IBM looked out way too comfortable. And the real test is whether Albrecht's going to push this for another point or whether they're just going to. IBM, it's just going to finish the game now. If you're looking for puns, Ibreak isn't a bad name to steal.
So many puns that come from Ibreak.
Run day with disc in hand. He's going to be pulling it back in. Pulled quite well today. It's really aggressive pulls to the back of the end zone. Blady once again rolls through. That allows the IBM defense to set up. And they look like they're using a poachy defense. Potentially zoning.
Let's go, Beam! Let's go, Beam! Get it on, get it on!
Oh, the sneaky, we're not playing zone.
Drop by Mitchell there. Yeah, right
drops on the end zone. Yeah, that's going to hurt. David with disc in hand. Looks to finish it in the end zone. Not on. Swings it to Stoddard. Flare off from Hayes. The leg kick up to just add that little bit of spice. And that's the score for the game. That is 15-4. IBM have rolled away with this game, taken it away. They're just too good in this winning conditions to a developing younger Outbreak Apocalypse team. Who started off the game well and just haven't been able to hold that speed. Again, it was, as we see, the play of the day from Yukon Discs. We thank Yukon for sponsoring this event. Please keep watching the streams as we see more games in stream. I believe next we have Canberra Factory versus Sydney Rogue Rage. Hashtag all the rope. Hashtag rage responsibly.
All the rage.
All the rage.
All the rage.
Makes a lot more sense.
All the rogue rage.
It makes a lot more sense.
It does.
All right, keep your eyes out for that one. Thank you very much, Narelle, for joining me.
No worries. Thanks, mate.